Citizen developers is not a new concept. It has existed for many years. Microsoft has provided different tools to business users to solve day-to-day business challenges, like Microsoft Access and Excel. In 2003, Microsoft released two very successful technologies. I'm talking about InfoPath and SharePoint Designer, that integrated with SharePoint Server provided the possibility to automate several business processes. However, those technologies were designed with different challenges in mind, different challenges than today's challenges. Today, businesses need to interact with process and data from anywhere and from any device. They need to access information and data through different data sources at the same time, and IT teams need to provide those solutions in less time and with less cost. Microsoft has released the Power Platform to solve today's business challenges, and day by day is providing new features to integrate in a collaboration environment with Microsoft 365. In this video, I'm gonna show you a modernized service request process using the Power Platform and Microsoft 365. So let's dive into it. Okay, so what we're gonna do here is we're gonna access as a requester. So I am here in Teams and I'm going to click on this application, which is the service request application. You can see here all my requests, previous requests I sent before, and I can filter by status. For example, those are my new requests and I can see all the details about this new request. You can see, for example, the different ticket managers assigned to those requests. I can also see the requests that are in progress. So you will see this one. I see not only the ticket manager, but also the engineer that has been assigned, and I can contact this engineer by a shadow email, right? The same here, we have different engineers and different ticket managers based on the category of the request I sent. We can see also the requests that have been closed and the closure date and the different roles assigned, and I can see more details if I need it, right? So let's create a new request. So the first thing I need to select is the request type or the category, basically, right? So we can select the networking, email, office suite. I am selecting networking. Here you can see the requestor information automatically. I get that information automatically from the app and also the information I need to populate. So let's populate this subject and description as a sample. Let's select this priority. I click on next, and here you can see the different service I can enable based also on the category I selected. You will see that while I select any specific service, other fields are going to appear, right? For example, in this case, I need to specify a reference IP. Let's populate this with a sample data, okay? And you will see also the ticket manager, which basically has been automatically identified based on the category of the request. So I submit this request and you will see that this request has been successfully created with all the data. This is a request number 166. And I automatically receive a notification in Teams. You will see here that I have received this notification with the request number, and all the information that I provided through the request form, and if I want, I can check the request. Now let's add it with a second role. This is going to be the ticket manager. You will see that the ticket manager has received an email with all the details related to this request, and if I want, I can click here to access the application and review this particular request, but in this case I'm just going to access through Teams, right? So you will see this new ticket, the 166, has been created. I have all the details related to this request and I can assign an engineer to this request. But before doing that, we're gonna go to this report. This is a Power BI dashboard
where I see all the pending requests and the ones that are in late. I see we see here the engineers, the requests that these engineers are working on, and we see that, for example, this engineer has bandwidth. So what I'm gonna do is assign that particular engineer to this request. So I click on this new request and I select the engineer Brandon Stevens, and then I click assign engineer. So you will see, if we go to in progress, you will see that this request is in progress now, and the engineer has been successfully assigned. So let's go back as a requester, and we will see that we have received another notification in Teams with the details that now my request is in progress and this is the engineer that has been assigned in this date. I can contact immediately the engineer. So let me write some text here. This is a communication that we can have with the engineer through Teams. Now we are going to access as an engineer. You will see that the engineer has received my message through Teams. But let's go to to Teams, and the engineer is going to receive this notification with all the details. So I can click on check request, and as soon as I click to that button, the application is going to open. So you will see that I as an engineer can see that this request has been assigned to me, and I can contact the requester. I have all the information here. So for example, I click on this button to chat, and I can open Teams and contact the requester, so we can communicate if I need an additional information, right? So let's say I finish this request. So I'm gonna close this request with a message. I click on confirm, and now this request is in the status of closed, right? Now let's go back as a requester. So now as a requester, I have received another notification with the details that, for example, this I can check the request if I want. So I'm gonna click here. I open the application. I see the request now is closed. I see the closure date, and I can click in this button to see more details. For example, this is the comment from the engineer, right? So I can go back to this notification card, and I can fill a survey to finish this process. So this is a form, a survey based on Microsoft form, and I can send the survey. Okay, so now let's try to do the same but using a bot. This is my IT service bot. I'm gonna interact with this bot as a requester. So the first thing is to select the action. This time is gonna be create a new request, a new ticket basically. The priority is gonna be high. The category is gonna be networking, and I want to assign a static IP. So I'm going to provide my IP. You will see, for example, I write my IP address is this one, and the bot is intelligent enough to identify from that text which is the IP, right? You will see that. And I provide a final comment here. So when I provide that information, the bot automatically has created my request, which is a 169 request. You will see here that. And you see that all the options I selected are part of my request name. And also you will see that the IP have been automatically identified by the bot, right? Now let's try to create a new request. Instead of selecting from the options, I'm gonna write, I want to create a new service request. So the bot is identifying from the text what I'm referring to, right? For example, in this case, instead of selecting any of the available priorities, I write urgent. And for the categories, you can see I need Wi-Fi access on my PC. You will see that the bot automatically have identified which category I'm referring to, right? And the same, for example, Wi-Fi enablement, and this is my MAC address or my physical address, my final comments, and the request 170 have been created, so I can access again to my request application, and you will see that the MAC address, the priority, the service, all the information have selected correctly. Now this is a third sample. This time I want to create another ticket, which is going to be medium priority. And I want to expand my mailbox. So you will see that automatically the bot have identified that I'm referring to the email category, and it provides me other options related to email. For example, expand the mailbox. I selected 100 megabytes and I'm providing more details. Now we have the 171 request created with all the information that I provide through the interaction with the bot, right? Now, let me go with this. This is the ticket manager responsible to assign engineers to requests related to email. So this engineer is assigned in this particular, sorry, this ticket manager is assigning this particular engineer. You will see that the request now is in progress, and this is the engineer that has been successfully assigned. So if I go back as a requester, and I'm gonna interact again with the bot, I need help, and this time I want to check a ticket status. So the bot is asking me about the request number is 171, and the bot automatically has provided the information that I need. My request is in progress.
In this solution, we have used Power Apps, Power Automate, Power BI, Power Virtual Agents, as well as SharePoint Online, Microsoft Teams, and Microsoft Forms. We have also used different interesting capabilities, like how to use custom adaptive scarves, as well as how to use Azure Cognitive Services like Luis. So I hope this information was helpful for you.